Building a D2L ePortfolio. In this video, I will show you how to assemble an ePortfolio in Desire to Learn. A D2L ePortfolio is a collection of digital artifacts that you may assemble into a format that can be styled and shared with others. As a finished product, your electronic portfolio can be used for a wide variety of reasons, from demonstrating your learning to showcasing a collection of your best work. Before we jump into D2L, I'd like to review a few key terms that you'll need to know as you begin to work on your electronic portfolio. First, we have artifacts. Artifacts are documents from your computer, such as Word documents, PDFs, or pictures. Next, we have collections. You can think of collections like folders on your computer. All of your individual artifacts can be grouped together into a collection. Finally, we have a presentation. The presentation is your electronic portfolio. This is what you'll want to create to showcase your work. Both collections and presentations can be used to organize and share your work. The main difference here is that a collection should really only be used to group your files together, while presentations, on the other hand, can be styled and are generally better at presenting your work. So let's jump into D2L to see how this all works. Let's say that I'm a student and I need to create an ePortfolio to display a collection of my work. I'll start off here on the D2L homepage. This is the first page that you see when you log into D2L. I click the ePortfolio link. This brings me into the ePortfolio tool in D2L. It's looking a bit empty here now, so let's fix that. First, I'll need to upload my artifacts that I want to share. I click My Items. I click Add. I click File Upload. I click Upload. I find the artifact that I want to upload. And I open it. I click Add. I click Next. Here I can change the name of my artifact. And I can give it a description. I click Save. I click Save and Close. I go back to the My Items tab. Here I can see that my artifact has been added. Now I repeat this process for the rest of the files that I need to upload. Okay, so now that I have my artifacts uploaded, I'll need to create my presentation. I click My Items. I click New Presentation. I give my presentation a name and a description. And I click Save. My presentation has now been created. I can preview my presentation by clicking the View Presentation link. This launches my presentation in a new window. So this looks okay, but it doesn't really fit the mood of my work. I'll close this preview window for now. To change the style or the theme of the presentation, I click the Theme tab. Here I have a bunch of pre-made themes that I can choose from. Notice that there are multiple pages here. I like this green theme. I click Select. I click Set Theme. Now I again preview my presentation. And the theme has been updated to the new green theme that I selected. Now let's change the banner. That's this text right here. I close the preview window. I click the Banner tab. I add my custom banner text. And I add a description. I click Save. And I again preview my presentation. Notice now that the banner text has been updated, and the description has been added right over here. Now let's add some content to this presentation. I'll close the preview window. I click the Content tab. Now, in this example, I have three pieces of writing that I'd like to share. So I'll go ahead and make three pages to display my content. I start with one page that has already been created for me. So I'll rename this page to the title of my work. I click the triangle. I click Page Properties. I rename the page to the title of my work. I click Save. And now my page has been renamed. So now I need to create two more pages for my other works. I click the New Page button. I give my page a title. I click Save. And again, I create another page for my last work. Now that I have three pages for each of my three writing samples, I'll start to add my content. I click my first page here. To add content to this page, I click Add Component. I click Text Area. In the Area Name box, I title my work. And in the Content Area, I will enter the text of my work. I have my text saved in a Word document, so I can simply copy and paste my work in. Keep in mind that as you add your text here, D2L gives you a number of formatting tools that you may use to further style your work. When finished, I click Save and Close. Even though my text is now presented on the page here, I also want to add my original artifact to this presentation. Again, I click Add Component. I click Artifact. And here I see a list of the artifacts that I have uploaded to the ePortfolio tool. You'll remember that I uploaded each of these artifacts earlier in this video. So I choose the artifact that I would like to attach to this page. I click Add. Now my artifact has been added to my portfolio. Let's take a look. Here is my text, and my PDF artifact is now shown as a downloadable document at the bottom of the page. This looks good, so I close the preview window. You'll need to repeat this process for any other document that you would like to add to your web page. Okay, so some time has passed, and I've added the rest of my content to my presentation. Now that I've styled my portfolio, and I've added all of my content, now it's time to share my portfolio. Remember that your portfolio or your presentation is basically a mini website, And like most websites, you can share your presentation by simply sharing your presentation's web address or URL. To do this, I go back to the Portfolio Tool homepage. I click My Items. I click the triangle next to my presentation. I click Share. And this pop-up window gives me some options about how I would like to share my portfolio. I'll choose this top option here, allowing me to share my presentation by simply sharing the URL. And now I can simply copy the URL displayed here, and I can share it anywhere on the internet. For example, maybe I'll email this link to my instructor. Or I can even post this link on a D2L discussion board. And that wraps up this video on the D2L ePortfolio tool. I hope this video was informative for you, and I thank you for watching.